It was around 1 a.m. They were knocked in our main door, and a bit of silence. And then the knock became a little bit furious, till I heard the gate collapsing and was very frightened of what was happening in our home. I started hearing footsteps, military boots, and gunshot. I ran to hide under my grandmother's bed. And then I still hearing a lot of gunshot. It was like a combat. Everything descended into panic. We were screaming, crying. No one knew what was happening. The whole family were dragged out and lined up against the wall like we were about to face the firing squad. The minute that passed felt like eternity for me. It was the first time I experienced raw fear and understood that how much we were at the mercy of that corrupt and dictatorial government.
How could you adapt to that experience? Misfortune come large and small, and life is full of them. Although we all have some degree of setback in our lives, but some people come back from it even stronger. The question is how they do it. One word: resilience. Now, from my life experience, I compiled 6 ways to build resilience. Change the narrative, most important. Changing the way we tell our story can put the power back into our hand. When I put a good distance between myself and the place where, as a child, you know, my father was persecuted, and as an adult, I was persecuted. My first urgent need at that moment is just to save myself. All my nervous system was only geared toward that one and unique and ultimate goal, just to save myself. What part of your experience you share and how you share it? Are you talking as a victim retelling the story, feeling helpless and hopeless, or as a survivor focusing on your strengths and the power you got from it? Eating wasn't priority. Drinking is no big deal. I can go for hours. If I sleep, I may just wasting valuable time to move away, you know, from the danger. Basically, the thing is you need to tell your story the way you want it to be told. Your misfortune is not just about only the traumatic part of your experience. It's also about how you overcome that setback. That is the most important message to tell people about it. I am here in that beautiful city of Edinburgh, talking in this panel. Just look at the list of people who will be speaking. I don't have those titles, but I am expert by experience. I turn my negative experience to an expertise. You know, the trauma that someone experienced is not just, for example, torture survival. It's not just about, you know, torture, but it's also about the loss of family, the fear of the journey of flying. Now, if you have a torture survivor in front of you, what, you know, you need to consider? How you turn your experience to expertise is matter. You are more than all your setback and suffering and challenges and difficulty. Face your fears. You know, the first point we just covered, change the narrative, is helpful for past struggles. one that we have gained enough distance from it to be able to get some perspective.
My first welcoming in the UK through the asylum system was to be put in detention, in immigration detention center. Many months of sacrifice to get here, and then in a point to go to score zero again. I was detained in Hammersmith, just next to Heathrow. Every second you just hear fly taking off, and every flight taking off, you're just thinking maybe next one I will be in that flight, and I'll go back and facing, you know, torture again.
But what about fears, you know, the anxieties, the worries that we experience in the here and now? You know, such as the fear of public speaking. You know, we cannot talk ourselves out of such fear. You know, the first step is to slowly expose yourself to the thing that scares you. Though fear may not be fully extinguished, we will likely have a greater courage to confront it. You know, you need to have a moral compass. After misfortune, we may come out bitter, and that's understandable. And not to get lost in a cycle of negativity, it is very important to have a moral compass.
I made a promise to myself that I'm not going to be defined by my experience, but make it a tool for progress and enlightenment. So ultimately, I turned my experience to something more positive, for a greater good. So then, next phase, I ask myself, what next now?
A moral compass is your ability to judge what is right and wrong and act accordingly.
I don't want to be defined by torture. I don't want to be defined by experience. So what next? So I put all those energy, all those anger into co-founding the Survivor Speak Out network with a couple of friends and freedom from torture. If I summarize, you know, the Survivor Speak Out network in one paragraph, it is a network of torture survivors who decide to use the difficult experience of persecution, torture, and life in exile to positively change people's perceptions, influence decision makers and policies, and create a world free of torture.
If your is all about revenge, so let be. But as well, be ready to face the full consequence of your decision and action. But if yours, values and ethics is about positivity, inspiration, motivation, integrity and love, that goes along with the higher resilience. Express your feeling. Some of us think we are strong. We don't want to cry because it will show that we are weak. You know, the feeling and emotion you are carrying is a burden. But by expressing them, you won't carry that burden alone. I know the power and benefit of therapy. I have done it and it's worked for me.
I was released from detention, and then I started struggling, you know, mentally, psychologically, with all the experience, part of my, you know, upbringing, that, you know, if you have a mental problem, so you have evil spirit. So I refuse completely, absolutely, to expose myself to the shame and the stigma which associated with the mental health.
Therapy will give you a greater understanding of what is going on inside your mind and how to deal with it. You know, when expressing your feeling with people you trust or who understand your pain, generally go from sorrow to frustration to joy, and you are less prone to burnout. Let's say you cannot get therapy, then talk to people, tell people you trust how you really feel. Practice self-compassion. You know, fears and adversity can make us feel alone. We wonder why we are the only one feeling this way, and what exactly wrong with us. In this situation, learning to practice self-compassion and you recognize that everyone suffers can be a much gentler and more effective road to healing. Self-compassion involves offering compassion to oneself, you know, confronting our own suffering with an attitude of warmth and kindness, you know, without judgment. Cultivate forgiveness. Let me tell you this, yeah. Holding a grudge is holding you back. Make a commitment to forgive, which means letting go of resentment and ill will for your own sake. One thing that people don't understand, they think that forgiveness is mean letting the offender off the hook or even reconciling with them. It's about you. It's about forgiving yourself of that guilt that you're carrying. So let me summarize. The stress and the struggles come in many forms in life. Adversity and trauma, fear and shame. Just remember that resilience is that amazing quality that allows some people to be knocked down by life and come back stronger than ever. Remember, whatever pain, adversity, setback, suffering, disappointment, and grief you experience right now, that too shall pass, as nothing lasts forever. There is more to you than what meets the eye. The average person ranks the fear of public speaking higher than fear of death. So next week, we will talk about how to overcome the fear of public speaking. So don't miss that. If you have not subscribed, just subscribe now. God bless you. Y estoy listo pa' tomar el castigo, yeah. Y todo lo prohibido, y los pecados que tú y yo hemos cometido.